A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 4th March, Monday. On the front page, you have ILNFS ignored risk assessment reports while extending loans audit. So, this is actually a forensic audit prepared by Grant Thornton, a private entity. We'll see the details. So, here you can see this forensic audit prepared by Grant Thornton. So, it says that there were serious lapses. In the manner in which huge loans were extended to certain entities by ILNFS. ILNFS was prominently in news. It is Infrastructure Leasing and Financial Services Authority Limited. So it's actually an umbrella organization. It has around 250 subsidiaries under it. So it extends loans for infrastructure purposes. And as we have seen that for infrastructure, when loans are extended for that purpose, they should be long-term loans. They would be repaid at a longer term because it takes time for infrastructure development. So, but then ILNFS was extending loans and using short-term loans to repay those long-term loans because it was not getting returns from these infrastructure companies. All this had resulted in a crisis. And ILNFS, as we have seen, is under a new management now. And presently, this audit report is bringing out serious lapses in the manner in which huge loans were extended to certain entities, even after internal risk assessment clearly showed that the borrowers were under financial stress. So if the borrower, maybe for any infrastructure purpose or financial purpose, the borrower is seeking loan from ILNFS and you know that the borrower is under financial stress and huge amount of loan being given. So that's the point raised here. The internal risk assessment of ILNFS clearly showed that. Then another various other instances have been found wherein the committee of directors of infrastructure financing company, that is ILNFS, extended loans at a negative spread to borrowers. So means negative spread, what is it, is explained here too. So the borrowers are facing liquidity issues, means again they are under financial stress, they do not have liquidity to repay the loan, and this negative spread basically means that in ILNFS is also borrowing money. So when it is borrowing money, the interest rate which it pays is high, while the interest rate at which it is extending the loan is low. You can see a negative spread occurs when interest rates charged on amounts lent are lower than interest rates paid on borrowed sum. So the ILNFS is paying on borrowed sum a higher interest rate than what it is getting from the loans which it is extending. So this is the whole thing. So ILNFS, you should understand, is an NBFC, non-banking financial company. So it cannot take deposits, but it can extend such loans. Then there are other things which have been highlighted in the report too. You can see there were 18 instances where the committee of directors ultimately approved loans to those borrowers who were under potential stress. On the basis of media reports and articles in public domain, and in spite of a negative assessment, as we saw by the internal risk team too, they were provided loans up to of about 2400 crore rupees. Then there are another 16 instances when cumulative loan of 1922 crores were extended with a negative spread or limited spread. So this is highlighted. Then so 7 loans were either written off or are related parties of the company for whom the loans were written off. So loans, writing off of loans have also come forth, means they are not expecting the loans to be repaid anymore. So it's like an NPA written off. So this is there. Also another 29 instances have been found where loans were given to entities whose group companies use the money to repay existing loans taken from ILNFS. As such, ILNFS Financial Services, which is a subsidiary of another ILNFS company, means the amount, you can see 29 such instances. So and loan amount is worth 2500 crore. So these loans were given to entities, to such businesses or infrastructure companies, who were using this money which is given as loan to repay the loan which it has taken from ILNFS subsidiary only. So all these are the details which have come forth in this forensic audit by Grant Thornton. Then below you have ICC rejects request to isolate Pakistan. So we had BCCI, Board of Control for Cricket in India, had approached International Cricket Council to isolate nation supporting terrorism. So it did not mention Pakistan, but it made such request, but then ICC has rejected such a request. Then this is India fortifying case to put Jaish on ban list. So we have seen how another attempt has been made to even declare Maulana Masood Azhar as a global terrorist at UN Security Council 1267 Sanctions Committee. And now India is fortifying this the case. So you can see the what our steps have been taken. It will show that the outfit is a threat to the West. So this is the detail regarding that. This is India nudges Myanmar action on Naga militants. So militants in Naga, NSC and K militants, they take refuge in Myanmar, the adjoining nation. So India is asking Myanmar to take action on these militants. So boost in bilateral ties are there presently because of crackdown in on training camps too. So Myanmar is taking action against training camps of Naga militants in Myanmar territory. On page 4, you have tribal leaders oppose CM's plan to support Dhangar case. So this is regarding Dhangar community. There is an ongoing case in court on giving ST status, scheduled tribe status, to Dhangars. So this is being opposed by tribal communities and ST leaders from opposition parties. They say we are not against extending economic benefit to the Dhangar community, but government must give them all possible aid, and we are happy for it, but they should not be included in the tribal sub-plan. So this is what they say. On page 5, you have Vidyal heralds a new dawn. Poachers turn protectors in Periyar. So this is Periyar Tiger Reserve of Kerala. So the poachers here have now turned into game keepers. They will be protecting the forest, so they have been roped in. So this is an initiative taken here, which is a win-win situation for all because they have skills and dedication. So you can see, so there are 17 such poachers which are now protecting the tiger reserve, winning respect for their skills and dedication. So a unique initiative benefiting all. On page 7, you have Rajdhani Express turns 50, passengers pampered with Rasgullas. So it's a golden jubilee run of Rajdhani train, and it was flagged off by former staffers after ceremonial cake cutting and release of stamps. And below you have a tale of six elephants using one corridor in two countries. So this is regarding a herd of six female elephants surviving under severe anthropogenic stress. So they may be held by transboundary conservation. That's what the scientists say. So for several years now, this group has been negotiating the international border between India and Bangladesh. So they go from western side, from Assam to the eastern side of Sylhet district of Bangladesh. So the transboundary conservation is being called for and advised by scientists here for conservation of the elephants. On the editorial page, the first editorial is The Week After. So this is regarding India's action against terror groups in Pakistan, the Balakot strike, and week after that. So you can see it says India must keep up diplomatic pressure on Pakistan to act against terror groups. So it should not be just an airstrike and forgotten, but India should keep pressure on Pakistan. And this is deepening slowdown. So this is regarding RBI's reduction in borrowing costs. So it says, can RBI's reduction in borrowing costs help check the demand slowdown? This is the editorial discussing about economic slowdown in India. So GDP growth projected, for the fourth quarter has also been brought down. The third quarter estimate has come down. So this revising down of GDP because of decline in growth. So that is what is being discussed in this editorial. And the lead article is Lines Being Crossed. So this is talking about reasons behind India's restraint after the 26/11 attacks. So why India did not take any such action post 26/11 attacks is discussed in this article. And this is The Basics Are Vital. So this talks about making hospitalization affordable. So it says that this will bring in relief and it says there's no alternative to strengthening primary health centers. Primary health care has to be strengthened. On op-ed page, you have failing the forest. So this is regarding the recent Supreme Court order in that context, where it called for those whose claims have been rejected should be evicted from the forest. So this article talks of how the Forest Rights Act, which has both aspects to it, a win-win situation that traditional forest dwellers and scheduled tribes should be given forest rights, plus they would help in conservation of the forests. But this article says how it has been seen that both human rights groups as well as wildlife rights groups have not used the Forest Rights Act as a conservation tool. On page 11, you have UK offers collaboration in fighter technology carriers. So UK High Commissioner says its partnership building exercise has been going on. So Indian Air Force, it wants to procure new fighter jets, and UK has made a pitch for cooperation in the field of building aircraft carriers and future fighter aircraft technology. So it says that we are not selling, it is a partnership building exercise which we want to initiate with India. So we need aircrafts. The Rafale deal as such, the original Rafale deal was scrapped. So only 36 Rafale jets have been procured so far. So we need many, many more, you can see. So IAF has floated a tender for 114 fighter jets. On international page, you have here SpaceX capsule docks on International Space Station. So SpaceX's new Dragon capsule successfully docked on ISS. So NASA and SpaceX both are working together. NASA is roped in private space companies. SpaceX is one such private space company of Elon Musk. So they are working together, and SpaceX capsule has now successfully docked with the International Space Station. So presently this capsule only has a dummy, it's not a manned mission, but the objective is to have manned missions sent to ISS. So then on business page, you have cumulative spending on CSR crosses 50,000 crore rupees. So this is regarding corporate social responsibility. 4 years ago, a legislature mandated that CSR has to be compulsorily done by companies. So now the spending has been high, and it has been used for various purposes, from health, education, to even for cultural heritage protection as such. Then this is Mudra, 1 lakh crore more has to be lent. So this is regarding the Mudra scheme. So under this scheme, small medium enterprises are provided with loans. So the lending target is of 3 lakh crore, and only about 2 lakh crore has been disbursed till February 22. So the financial year ends in less than a month, and 1 lakh crore has to be still lent. This is the Mudra. You should know is Micro Units Development and Refinance Agency Limited. So this is Mudra Bank, which has been established to implement the Mudra scheme for providing loans to these micro enterprises. Then this is Niti Aayog to draw up list of non-core assets of central public sector enterprises for monetization. So this process, it may take 6 months, and it wants to prepare such list of assets like land, building, etc. of such PSUs, so that they can be sold off and money raised. Then on business review page, you have this coverage on gold. So it says demand for gold has been dropping in India, but RBI has recently increased the gold holding in its reserves. So after 2009, now in 2018-19, it has done so. So this shows regarding gold demand and the rate of growth of gold you can see in the country. And this is regarding gold. So gold for jewelry remains a steady component. You can see the darker shade is for gold for jewelry, and gold for investment is a small chunk. Then banks are also buying gold. You can see the buying of gold by banks has increased in 2018, and this is regarding the gold reserve as such of RBI, which again it has increased. So you can see it's from 2009, it had done a significant jump in having gold in its reserve, and now it has increased this again in 2018. Then below here you have India's electric vehicle success story will ride on two wheels. So for two wheelers, electric vehicles, electric scooter as such, it is said will be 4 to 6 times more efficient than a petrol scooter. So, adoption of electric two-wheelers will need cheaper lithium-ion batteries, increasing charging speed, and improved charging infrastructure. So, that has been proposed here. So, there's no news on the last page. So, these are the important headlines from the Hindu newspaper. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website ahr.com in the current affairs section. So, here you have the current affairs PDFs uploaded. So, these PDFs can be downloaded too. Plus, also, you can there are full news videos which are prepared. A sample is provided here, and the details of this course is provided up here. So, that is it. Thank you.